Next question. This came in 1998 for 8 marks. Nuclei of radioactive element A are produced at a constant rate alpha. A is produced at constant rate alpha. Okay. The element has a decay constant of lambda. It has a decay constant of lambda. At t equal to 0, there are n0 nuclei. N0 nuclei are there. Okay. You need to find out number of nucleases after time t. Oh. So this nuclei is not only disintegrating, but also it is getting produced.
Sir, so this is just n naught e to the power minus lambda t minus alpha into t.
The alpha will be increasing or decreasing the nucleus?
Oh, yeah. Oh, sir. Oh, so then this, okay, so an alpha t minus n naught e to the power minus lambda t, since alpha is the production rate.
But as alpha produces, those nucleus will also get decayed, right, with time. So it's not a straightforward. You can't separate these two processes.
Okay, sir. Okay.
You need to solve a differential equation. Okay, should I do it?
Yes, I got it.
Okay. Is this what you get? See, suppose it is only getting created. So d by dt will be equal to what? Alpha. And since it is getting decayed, dn by dt will also be equal to minus lambda times n. Fine. So this is production and this is decay. So total rate will be the summation of these rates, which will be equal to alpha minus lambda So this is the differential equation you have, which you have to solve. Dn divided by alpha minus lambda n is equal to dt. Fine. And this is what you have to integrate from n naught to n. That integration part you will do, right?
Yes.
Rapture and Kondanya, are you following? And Sant?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, I'm following.
Sure. Okay. Now write down if. Today we are doing only problem solving Siddhant, as many of you have exams in the school. We are using this opportunity to discuss as many questions as possible. So alpha is equal to 2n naught lambda. If alpha is 2n naught lambda, this B part of the same question, okay? Calculate the number of nuclei of A. How many nuclei of A after half-life of A? Okay. And as T tends to infinity, what is the number of nucleus of A tends towards? I hope this is what the expression you might have got. Are you getting this expression?
Yes, sir. Yeah.
Once you integrate this differential equation, you'll get that expression, okay? And then alpha is 2 n naught lambda. Substitute it and get the value of number of nucleus after t half. T half should be log 2 by lambda. T half is log 2 by lambda. Substitute that. Anybody got the answer?
Is it 2 n naught into n lambda minus 1?
It is actually 3 by 2 n naught.
Yeah, I'm getting that.
Okay, and when t tends to infinity, n becomes equal to 2 times n naught. How it becomes 2 times n naught? Because this term will go to 0 as t tends to infinity. So this goes to 0, and this is a multiplication with 0. So only alpha by lambda remains, and alpha is 2 n naught lambda. So that is straightforward.
Yeah, seems
so. Okay. So I hope you are appreciating that even though modern physics is simple, but you can't take it for granted. Okay. All right. Fine. So let us take these ones. This came in 2003. For 2 marks. A radioactive sample emits n beta particles. It emits n beta particles in 2 seconds. Okay. And it emits 0.75 n beta particles. N is a number, okay? N times beta, sorry, n beta particles, okay, then 0.75 n beta particles, it will emit in next 2 seconds. Are you getting my point here?
Yes, sir.
What is the mean life of the sample? As in T average, that is how much, which is 1 by lambda as a formula. Anyone got the answer? No?
So 2 by lambda 4 by 3.
Yes. Correct. See, n beta particles in first 2 seconds. So you can say that initially its rate is proportional to n. Okay. And then I can say n by 2, then dn by dt after 2 seconds, 0.75 n by 2, fine. So if you take the ratio, you're basically getting a ratio of n1 is to n2. This is proportional to number of nucleus initially, this is number of nucleus finally. So when you divide it, you'll get log of 1 divided by 0.75 is equal to lambda into t, and t is what? 2 seconds. So lambda is equal to 1 by t times log of 3 by 4. So you can get 1 by lambda, which is the average life, that is t divided by log 3 by 4. Okay. This is 4 by 3. Silly error. Okay?
Okay, sir.
Fine. Let us move to next question.
So can you do some from atoms also?
Atoms. Achha, just one more question, then we'll take a few from atoms, okay? This I wanted to take up because this is a unique type of question. It came in 2001 for 5 marks. Okay. Understand the question, okay? A radioactive nucleus X, you can also write with me, X decays into Y. With a decay constant of lambda x. Decay constant is lambda x. Y further decays into stable nucleus Z. Stable nucleus means it will not decay. Z will not decay. With lambda Y as decay constant. Okay. Initially, there are only X nuclei. At t equal to 0, only X nuclei were there, okay, and the number is N naught, which is 10 raised to power 20. I mean, let's find out everything in terms of variables only. So number of X nuclei initially were N naught. Okay. You need to first write down the rate equations for X, Y, and Z. Rate equation means what? Dx by dt kitna hai, dy by dt what it is, and dz by dt how much it is. Rate equations for X, Y, and Z. And then you need to prove that number of nucleuses Y as a function of time is given as N naught lambda X divided by lambda X minus lambda Y e to the power minus lambda Y t minus e to the power minus lambda xt. Okay, do this for are you guys getting it?
Yes, just a minute.
This is exactly like sequence reactions in chemical kinetics.
Oh yeah. Chemical kinetics. So you have derived something like this in chemical kinetics.
Yeah, so that second, yes, that expression you have to prove is exactly the same.
Oh, so you know this already. So rate at which the X is changing. First of all, it should be negative rate. X number is going down. This is equal to minus lambda X and X.
Yeah.
Okay. And the rate at which Y is changing. See, when X is changing, it will increase Y. Fine. So minus lambda X and X is decrease in X, but it is increase in Y. So it will be,
yes,
lambda X and X minus lambda Y and Y. Okay. And can you tell me what is d and z by dt? How much that is equal to? See, z is only created. It is not decaying. And that is created because y is disintegrating. So this is
lambda
y and y only. Fine. Now I need to find ny as a function of time. So how will I integrate this particular expression? Because here I have one variable, two variable, and time as a three variable. So I need to have at max three variables, right?
Yeah, you can use nx is equal to ny e to the power.
What?
So you can use the disintegration equation, right? N naught is equal to n. N is equal to n naught e to the power minus k.
Right. So lambda naught e to the power minus lambda x into t. Fine. So once you write it like this, what we have done is that we have written nx variable as a function of time. So now we have reduced and we have eliminated the nx variable, so we have now only three variables. This we can integrate to get the value of ny. Okay. Any idea how should we integrate this? How should we go about integrating this? T N Y.
So you can multiply it with e to the power lambda or 2 or lambda y into t.
Okay.
So then you'll get it. Then you'll get it as a differentiation, like as a derivative of y. So then like that you can.
So wait, lambda y, n y, you know, they're all constants, right?
Lambda y is constant, n y is not a constant. Okay, so once you integrate this, you'll get this particular expression. Now there is a second part in which it is asked at what time ny is maximum. So once you get ny, just take a derivative of ny and equate it to zero. So you'll get time at which ny will be maximum. And then at that time, what is the value of x, z, and y nucleuses, right? So that's how you do those kind of questions, okay? So we'll take a small break. We'll meet after 10 minutes. Is it fine?
Yes, sir.
So right now it is 6:13, so we will meet at 6:23.